The answer is an action thriller that's listed as Saw Meets the Fugitive, which is a terrible description of the movie. It's about a guy who's living a normal, boring life until he gets a message from his dead parents, and then all hell breaks loose. He just started dating this girl from work, and after almost being killed by a team of motorcycle helmet-wearing bad guys, they go on the lam trying to uncover the truth. I get the comparison with the fugitive since he's on the run, but Saw? There's some puzzles his parents left behind for him to figure out, but that's about it. Not even deadly puzzles, just like a video game one and another where he has to remember his favorite color. Despite the misleading description, this was a lot better than I was expecting. The chemistry between the two leads was really endearing. Brid, the hero, played a believable, socially awkward guy thrust into this situation. Charlotte, the girlfriend, was incredibly likable, and aside from some lame forced drama towards the end, their relationship felt genuine. The story was interesting, although I do think they made the reveal of who he was a little too early. They should have hung on to that a bit longer, because it did do a lot to deflate the mystery. There was enough suspense to keep me engaged till the end, though. It did feel like they were setting things up for a potential sequel, but they had a definitive ending in case that never happens. The downside was that some of the action was bad. There were a few scenes where Brid's supposed to be doing these amazing feats, and they end up being these slow and clunky sequences. I'm this incredible badass! And then it goes into this sort of half-hearted, we couldn't afford a stuntman interpretive dance. At times the movie did feel a little too much like a soap opera. The drama was pushed more than the thriller aspects, which might turn off some people. I didn't mind it too much, but it was noticeable. As is seemingly the new trend, the effects are mostly low-budget stock CG and a couple of practicals. Some slowing down and speeding up time, throats slashed, stabbings, and that sort of stuff. The cover art is incredibly misleading. It makes it look like more of an action film with Robo-Batman here. While this guy is in it, it's really just a bunch of guys in the same outfit. They're the henchmen of the main villain. They do have those cool blades though, but I have a feeling they're props borrowed from another film. The Answer is a surprisingly fun little thriller. The story, while not the most original thing, was still interesting and unique in its own way. It's also one of the better looking lower budgeted films I've seen in a while. So many are shot on digital with no processing, so it's overly obvious that it's digital. This had a look that was closer to film. The movie felt like the direct-to-video movies of old, where they weren't trying to be anything more than enjoyable. Not a great film, but a solid bit of entertainment for about 80 minutes.